All right, shalom, shalom, Yasharala. Back at it again with another Lord with an edifying video through the spirit and the power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Bachachwarash. Before I go any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Bachachwarash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders, the great millstone, who still go out there on the highways and hedges and feed us with 100% true according to the Bible and Ruel. Inshallah, Labachoyim, Wabarakim, Shayasharala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel in the Lashawan Kodash, the Hebrew tongue. And pretty much the name of this lesson is going to be called Is Babylon the Great So Different? All right. Just to kind of use a code word or code name for the title. But I'm going to go into how the Lord overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah for one of the same wickedness that they're doing in these times, right? So I'm going to start off with the book of Jude, the 7th verse. And it says, even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, right? Because the Lord destroyed five cities in total. It was Sodom, Gomorrah, Zoar, Adma, and Zeboam. Okay, when the Lord took Lot and his two daughters and his wife out of this particular city, that's when the Lord proceeded to bring fire out of heaven to destroy these five cities, right? Which I'm going to get that account. This is the book of Jude, the 7th verse. It says, even at Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, right, they was all destroyed, giving themselves over to fornication, which we know fornication is idol worship, man, or spiritual adultery. All right, because you got these wacky techie Christians saying that fornication is sex before marriage. Well, they don't know the scriptures, man. It's talking about worshiping these false idols and philosophies that's out here, right? Because that's what our people was into in them times as well. Idol worship, and that was big. And it reads, and going after strange flesh. Oh, we know what that's talking about. It's going into sodomy or homosexuality, right? But the word strange means foreign, okay? And it reads, because men and women and women, that's a strange and foreign and unfamiliar thing, all right? Because it's unnatural, right? And it says, are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire, right? Because it was the Lord, you know, rained fire and brimstone from heaven to destroy those five cities for mainly the homosexuality, but it was also doing zoophilia, which is bestiality. It was idol worshiping, you know what I'm saying? There was committing adultery, you know, so on and so forth, man. All right, it was a whole bunch of wickedness going on. So Babylon the Great, which is America, is even worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. So how much more in these times of the destruction of Babylon the Great, right? Let me see. That was pretty much the point on that. I got a little bit of a commentary on that verse. I'm going to grab some more precepts. Not a long lesson. It says, Jude, the 7th verse, right? It says, Sodom and Gomorrah are mentioned often in Scripture as examples of the Most High's, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah's severe judgment on sexual sin, right? Which we know sin is the breaking of the laws. Now, what sexual sins were they breaking during the time of Sodom and Gomorrah, all right, in the five cities? Mainly homosexuality. Like I said, they was doing bestiality. You know what I'm saying? Incest, adultery. You see what I'm saying? You know, they was doing all types of necrophilia, pedophilia, you know? So Yahweh Bashem Yahusha put a harsh judgment on that place, right? And it says, in particular sexual perversion, which we know perversion goes back to wickedness, man. Okay, so Yahweh Bashem Yahusha destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah and the other three cities because of their sexual sins, man, their sexual wicked filthy acts, which is an abomination. So now let's get the book of 2 Peter, right? The 2 Peter, I believe it's the 2nd chapter. Don't got anything written down. This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, verse, I'll start at verse 5. This is 2 Peter 2, verse 5, but the point's in verse 6. And it says, in verse 7, and it says, and spare not the old world, which the word world there is cosmos, right? Talking about our people. But saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness. He was a prophet, man. And what was he prophesying about? He was prophesying that it was going to rain while he was building an ark, man. And he did that for over 100 years. I believe it was like 126 years. He prophesied about the flood, you know. But our people back then, they didn't hearken to Noah, right? Okay. Because he was prophesying and they didn't believe him. And it says, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, right? So our people got destroyed, man. Okay. And everybody else. Okay. They saved Noah. You know what I'm saying? His son's wives. You know what I'm saying? And his wife, man, which is 8 souls. Okay. I think you got the unclean animals, which was by twos, and the clean animals or the lawful animals by sevens, man. You see? Into the ark. That's the only thing that survived, right? And it says, verse 6, and it says, and turn the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow. Right, yeah, they got condemned, man. They got judged or destroyed for their sins, man. You see, just like the two-thirds in these times, they're going to be accountable for the sins that they commit. While the elect of the nation of Israel, which we're hoping to be those men, sins are going to be pardoned, okay? There's going to be forgiven. But the two-thirds, they're going to be destroyed for the sins that they have committed on this side, right? And it says, with an overthrow, which means destruction, and making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly, right? See? And how much more in these times, man? Because Babylon the Great, which is America, is more wicked than the Sodom and Gomorrah, man. With this transgender thing, man, come on, man. You can't tell from a man or from a woman, which we can, the men of the Lord, because of Yahweh Shema Shah put the spirit on the sermon on us. But, you know, just in general, man, you can't tell from who. Okay? So how much more destruction that this place is going to be judged, man? The greatest, wickedest kingdom that ever the Lord established in the face of the earth is going to get the greatest judgment. It's only right. So now, as a matter of fact, verse 7, it says, and delivered just Lot, which the word just mean a righteous, vexed with a filthy conversation of the wicked, which the word conversation meaning conduct. And how was the wicked of our people conducting themselves during these times, man? During the times of Lot, living their lives contrary to the scriptures, man. All right? And it says, verse 8, for that righteous man, which is Lot, dwelling among them and seeing and hearing, vexed his righteous soul, which is a spirit, from day to day with their unlawful deeds, man. One of the main ones was homosexuality, which is a sin according to the Bible. When you read Leviticus 20 and 13, Leviticus 18 and 22, Romans the first chapter, and 1 Corinthians the ninth chapter, the sixth chapter, right? Verse 9, the Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptations, which are the things that try to make us go off, right? That's temptations. And to reserve the unjust, which is the unrighteous, the two-thirds, unto the day of judgment to be punished, right? So that's self-explanatory. So let's get that account about Sodom and Gomorrah, since we're pretty much evolving around that scripture, right? Let's see where I want to start. This is the book of Genesis 19. Let's see here. I'm gonna skip around. This is Genesis 19 and verse 4. I'm gonna start there and then I'm gonna skip around just for time's sake. Just Genesis 19 verse 4. But before, matter of fact, hold on. Verse 2, it says, and he said, behold, now my lords, turn in, I pray you, into your servant's house, and tarry all night, and wash your feet, and ye shall rise up early and go your ways. And they say, nay, but we shall abide in the street all night. Which is going into the two angels, right? That visited Lot, and he pressed upon them greatly. And they turned unto him and entered into his house, and he made them a feast, and did bake unleavened bread, and they did eat. Right. Which was, it was looking like they eat, because we know the angels don't eat. Verse 4, but before they lay down, the men of the city, and even the men of Sodom, compassed the house round, both old and young, all the people from every quarter. And they called unto Lot, and said unto him, where are the men which came unto thee this night? Bring them out unto us, that we may know them. Right. And that word know them in the sword, it says to know them carnally, which we know carnally meaning of the flesh. So they wanted to have sex with them. Okay. So that was big during the times of Sodom and Gomorrah. That was one of the main reasons why, you know, the Lord destroyed it. So now I'm going to go to verse 24. Let's get to the point. Then the Lord rained fire. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and Gomorrah. Sodom and upon Gomorrah fire and brimstone from the Lord out of heaven. And he overthrew those cities and all the plain, even all the inhabitants of the city, that and all that grew upon the ground. Right, see, because they said even the old and the young men wanted to lay down with the angels, man. So, hey, how much more in these times? And this place is more wicked than the Sodom and Gomorrah. So, Lord's windows are edifying through the spirit. Pavi, Yahweh, Shimei, Shabbat, Shimei, Kapodash. Till next time, the Lord's will, I say Shalom.